Frank, how are you?
Good. How are you?
Spectacular. What are you going to do all day?
Well, I'm on this mythical thing called an off day, so I haven't moved from my bed yet.
Are you in bed right now?
Yeah.
What's your crib look like?
It's an elegant little 3-bedroom apartment. It's got some nice stuff in it.
Like what?
I bought a nice couch, big recliner. It has no art, though. That's what I've been looking to upgrade to. I need some art. Need some help.
Well, just ease into it when you buy art. Therefore, if you may make a mistake or two, it's not an expensive mistake.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't buy the expensive art to begin with. I don't have expensive taste.
What about posters, maybe?
Yeah. You know, I've been trying to move away from the posters, with like some text in the wall, but I might be getting to that point.
Did you have posters at Wisconsin?
I did, all over the place.
Of who?
It's college. You got to have it. I had Entourage posters. I had some Space Jam posters. Some other random stuff, like those people that do those spray paint things on the sidewalks in like cities, make cool pictures. I had a couple of those. Those are cool.
Did you have a black light or a lava lamp?
No, I didn't. I felt like that would have been too much.
Is it boring? Like in college, you could go to class, you could hang out with your guys, but now you're a pro. Now you're a grown up, Frank.
I don't know if I'd put it that way yet. I definitely feel older, but I don't know. If you ask my mom, she definitely wouldn't call me a grown-up.
Are you having fun?
Yeah, I'm having a lot of fun. But you know my personality. I'm the kind of guy that can have fun with pretty much any situation.
But you were always the main guy. The ball went through you, certainly in college, I'm sure in high school. And now, how different is the role, though, with Charlotte, where it's not going to you and you're not the man on the team?
I'm just finding my role. I'm a rookie. I'm coming into a new situation with a completely different team. So I'm just finding my way. I'm getting more comfortable more and more every game. So I'm enjoying it. I'm having a lot of fun with it. Obviously, it's a lot different than college, but, I expected that and, I'm just growing. Like you said, I'm growing up.
Rookie hazing?
There's not much. On the road, I got to go get, like, breakfast and lunch and stuff for people, but I don't really mind doing any of that.
What's the biggest tab you've gotten stuck with? No dinner tabs, right?
No. I don't really know.
Oh, well, that's good.
I don't really buy much.
Yeah, well, as long as they're going to stick you with a big dinner here before the end of the year.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure of it. But yeah, as long as I get to eat something nice, I'm cool.
What's your welcome to the NBA moment?
What, as far as
on the court, on the court, like where you went, I just got indoctrinated, or everybody has one of those moments where they go, oh, it's a little bit different here in the pros.
Well, I was playing defense on Dirk, and he came off the screen, and he kind of just ran into me, and I didn't think I fouled him, but apparently the referee saw it the other way. I was like, oh, back to the bottom of the totem pole.
Now you know how the rest of the Big Ten felt covering you last year, Frank.
I don't know if it was that bad, but yeah, I guess you could say that.
Did Nowitzki do that little put the foot out and shoot that jumper there that he has?
I didn't guard him for very long, so I didn't get an opportunity. But he actually ran off the screen on me and got open, and I was praying he didn't make it, and he didn't. So I felt kind of good about that.
So you shut down Nowitzki is what you're telling people.
For a minute and 25 seconds where he touched the ball twice.
I like that. He's Frank Kaminsky, the Hornets forward, joining us, Dan Patrick Show. We were just talking about, in fact, in Charlotte there with Cam Newton. Everybody's all, got an opinion on his dancing and, the whole younger athletes celebrating. What do you think of celebrations in sports?
I think, especially in football, it's become a part of the game. And for people to get upset about one person doing it is just completely ridiculous in my mind. Because you see people do crazy end zone dances, things that you can tell they've practiced, and just because, you know, one person or one fan base gets upset doesn't mean, you know, you can have an outcry over one person. You know, if you're gonna get upset at everyone that does it.
Are you in fantasy? You do fantasy football?
I do fantasy football.
Any incidents?
There is a major incident that happened in our fantasy football league this year.
Uh-oh.
There was an outcry over a trade that happened. It was Odell Beckham and Tom Brady for LeGarrette Blount, Joseph Randle, Antonio Gates, and Matt Ryan. And that's, and you know, we thought we were a league of stand-up, honest gentlemen, and we stood for what's right in the world. And you know, the trade ended up going through because not everyone understood the vetoing system. And pretty much after that point, you know, I have the worst team in the league this year. I'm not going to lie. So I was acting like it was the worst thing that ever happened to me, but it really had no effect on me because I wasn't going to beat anyone. The only game I've won this year is because the other guy forgot to put in one of his quarterbacks. So I won by two.
Do you want to name names? Frank, do you want to name names here?
I don't know if I want to name names. I don't want to hurt anyone's ego, but you know, they know who they are.
Are you in a fantasy basketball league?
No, I'm not. I only did it once when I was in like fifth grade.
Are you allowed to be in a fantasy NBA league?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah, they might frown. Yeah, they might frown upon that. Have you seen Michael Jordan since you got drafted?
I have. He's the owner. He's been around.
Yeah, what's he say to you?
You know, just positive stuff. Just saying, stick with it, and all those different things. You know, asking me how I'm doing. You know, as far as basketball, you know, he kind of leaves that up to the coaching staff.
You think you could take him one on one?
No, I wouldn't want to try.
Oh, of course you would.
I don't know if I would.
Like, you don't want to beat one of your heroes? Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm actually saying the opposite. I don't want to lose.
Oh, yeah. You could take Jordan. You better be able to beat Jordan.
See, that's what you would think.
Yes. Now, he thinks he could beat you.
Yeah, I think he could beat me, too. So, no, that's two people on one side.
But then he should be playing for the Hornets, Frank.
I think owning the team is a pretty cool gig, too.
What did you think of Porzingis? You got to see him, last week?
Yeah. You know, he's going to be a very good basketball player. You know, I had the opportunity to, you know, talk to him and hang out with him through, you know, a bunch of different stuff. And, you know, just being able to see, you know, how he's progressed this quickly after, you know, sitting at the draft and hearing everyone boo him. You know, it's great to see him doing so well.
You guarded him for a little bit, didn't you?
Yeah. I mean, he's taller and longer than he gets credit for. I mean, he's got a good, I'm 7 feet tall and he's got a good 2-3 inches on me. But you know, he's got a crazy amount of skill and, you know, a really bright future in front of him.
Well, have fun, continue to have fun. And, we appreciate you joining us as always, Frank.
Thanks for having me.
All right, that's Frank Kaminsky. Go back to sleep, Frank.